I would like to talk to you about a building, specifically Building 20 at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology. This building was not made to look pretty. It was a structure that was built out of necessity during World War II, and it was only ever meant to be a temporary fix. Building 20 was a 200,000 square foot three-story building, and it was thrown together very quickly. And apparently you could tell because the design of the building was entirely inefficient. It had these long corridors, and people would often comment that the place was like a maze and they would often get lost. Many of the resident students were packed into really small rooms, and the building was completely overcrowded. It barely met safety standards. But despite all this, it quickly became a furnace of innovation, and during its early years it was home to a number of Nobel Prize winners. Building 20 stood for more than 50 years, and during this time, it continued to be a melting pot of innovation. And this is because it was filled with students from across all disciplines, biologists, physicians, engineers, all thrown together in this really small space. And those long, windy corridors meant that people had time to engage in conversations, meaningful interactions that sparked ideas and collaboration. Not to mention the fact that nobody really cared about the building, so they could do what they want to it. They didn't have to ask permission. Students were free to modify their space to suit their needs, knocking down walls, knocking through the floors in some cases, and this freedom gave them a sense of ownership and autonomy over their space. Now, I'm certainly not suggesting that we should let our teams knock the walls down, but there are two lessons here. It's not about the space in which you work, it's about what you do with that space. Keep in mind that innovation often thrives under constraints and limitations, not abundance. The second point, don't be too busy to make time for impromptu conversations in the corridor. You never know where they can lead. Interestingly, Building 20 was knocked down in 1998 and replaced by a state-of-the-art facility designed to inspire innovation. Although, ironically, it hasn't yet seen anywhere near the notable success of its predecessor. If you have any thoughts to share around this topic, please feel free to do so below. My name's Joe Graciano. I am the Managing Director of Growth EQ, and I will see you again. Thank you.